So I just wanted to give you a quick little update here, progress report on what's happening in the art journal. I added some black outlines to this to give it some more dimension and depth. I don't know if the little blue lines inside this will show up on this camera or not. But I think that's as far as I'm going to take this page. I consider this one to be finished. Over here on my pastel, the original pastel, remember I was telling you about, I took some colored pencils and put it on the white areas of this. I like it a lot better. It feels better with the pink added to the different areas. This was a little cartoonish fish painting that I had created. I used my water-soluble oil pastels and colored them on and then wet them with water to give this painterly effect. And I had this in my collage bag and decided that it would make for some nice collage pieces. And I cut it into strips. You can see the different strips here. And what I am doing with these pieces, I am assembling them onto this page with an image of a face. This was an actual photograph that I cut out of a Vogue magazine. Now, on my Kate the Mermaid page, I put these mosaic pieces all around there, and I have started to put some text in with my gel ink pen. I'm using blue at this point. I might have to change my color because it's not showing up that well on this turquoise background. But that's what I will be doing next on there, is adding some text. And then over here, we've got our little blondie. I'm still developing her. Mixed up some very nice greens to put as a background color on this page, but they're not the right green. So I took the green that I had and I added some red to it to make it more of a blackish, grayish color. And I used a Sharpie marker to darken the lines around the edges here, and since that is permanent, I won't have any bleeding. I managed to get a very nice textured background on this page because I was using a very stiff bristle brush, and it's always fun to paint over those textured backgrounds to see the patterns emerge underneath, beneath. Using my king size Sharpie, so just to wrap this up a little bit, show you the various patterns in the background here, try to give you a close-up. I might even darken this a little bit more. This is the Kate the Mermaid page, and this is Kate Blanchett, the image from the Vogue magazine that I cut up, and then I added some details, some lines and graphics to the page. And during the course of making this video, I've called poor Kate, Kate Beckinsale, Kate Blanchett, Kate Winslet, you know, it's actually Kate Blanchett. What can I say? I never know when I'm making these videos what is going to come out of my mouth and show up on the video. So, there we are.